have your attention for a quick minute? So because we got a little bit of a late start, we're going to allow the premium items to stay open for auction until 7 p.m. What time is it now? It's 6:40, so we got 20 more minutes on the premium items. And then everything else will stay open until 7:15. So we're extending that a little bit because the meal got started a little late. No troubles about that. You know, one of the things is I promised myself at the end of last year I was going to stop referring to myself as the new headmaster. So I'm not the new headmaster anymore. But one of the things I, as the recently not new headmaster, like to do is listen to the stories of the people who've been here for a while. Right? I love to hear Tom Thistleton's stories. I love to hear the stories of other teachers and parents who've been here for a while. And I think that stories are some of the best ways to know the true heart and soul of a people and a place. So I love to hear those stories about Mars Hill. And to hear one of the things we did interestingly new at Grandparents Day, just on Friday, I started a student panel. We had some juniors and seniors up there, a student panel, and invited the grandparents in just to talk to them freely. And about 8 grandparents came. They loved it. They seemed to really be jazzed to talk to the kids about whatever they wanted to talk to them about. And to hear these students spontaneously talk about their growth and appreciation of truth, goodness, and beauty. They weren't prompted. I didn't give them a script. I didn't tell them what to say. I had no idea what they were going to say. But to hear them talk about the value of the education that they are receiving was a great blessing to me, and I hope to those parents as well. One of the things, you might not know this about me, I was a music major in college, so I'm always keen to pay attention to the musicians among the students, and the music teachers hate it when I come on board because they know I'm looking at them with a special light. And I do love to encourage a musical culture at the schools where I work. And one of the highlights at Mars Hill is Sonia Wirt. I don't know if you've ever had the privilege of hearing Sonia play the classical guitar, but she is one of the most gifted musicians I've ever met, and she's only in the 7th grade. So at this point, I'd like to introduce Sonia Wirt to come and regale us with her talents and abilities. Sonia, where are you? Sonia? She's from... Oh! Sonia, you going to come and play for us? While she's making her way over, I went to hear a concert several years ago of Andre Watts play at Avery Fisher Hall in New York City. Andre Watts is a renowned pianist, and I was so disappointed when I left the music hall because he played all the notes right, but there was no music there. If you understand the difference between what I'm saying, he played all the notes, but there was no heart and soul. It was as if a machine had been programmed to play the music. And this is one of the things I love about Sonia. When I listen to Sonia play, she is so far beyond playing the notes. You're actually listening to the heart and soul of the music. Sonia, do I need to give you my microphone? Okay. So, Sonia Wirt. Thank you, Sonia. Thank you. Thank you, Sonia. I told you, music, not just the notes. Next, I would like to introduce Kara Admiral. Kara, are you with us? Are you? There you are. Okay, here comes Kara. You know, I said a minute ago that we had the seniors and juniors speak to the grandparents, and I had no idea what they were going to say. Kara's here to share with you what Mars Hill means to her, and I'm sure it will be wonderful, but I have no idea. So,
I don't either.
Okay. Thanks, Kara, for being with us.
Hello, my name is Kara Admiral, and I'm a senior at Mars Hill Academy. I've been attending Mars Hill since kindergarten, and my family has been a part of this community for about 20 years. My two brothers have already graduated from Mars Hill, and my oldest brother, Tristan, even met his wife, Grace, here. It's weird to think that I'm almost done with my education, but reflecting on my time here has brought a very important thing to my mind, and that is the relationships that I have developed over these last 13 years. When I was younger, I would always see the older kids walking and talking in the hallways. Many of the older students would recognize me, for they knew my older siblings, but I would not recognize them. As I joined the athletic and theater program, and as I entered the logic and rhetoric school, I became friends with them and worked alongside them through various leadership positions, such as Highland Council, Worldview Summit, and a volleyball and jump rope coach. Through these activities, I made deeper relationships with some of the younger students. Specifically, for the past 2 years, I've taken on the responsibility of making a buddy system for the entire volleyball program. Through this, I've become really close with many of them. And when I see them walking through the hallways, I cannot help but smile, give them hugs, and ask how their day is going. Recently, my friend Alex Anderson and I, along with other of my classmates, have been going outside during lunch to play with the kids. A few days ago, a younger student asked Alex, "When will you come outside and play with us again?" This melted my heart. Though we cannot go outside every single day, I do treasure the small moments of pushing them on the swings, or chasing them around the playground, or even just talking with them. Though the kids enjoy it, I think I enjoy it even more. I also enjoy the relationships between the teachers and the students. All the teachers care about the students. Not only do they say hello, but they also ask how we are doing. And if we are stressed or overwhelmed, they understand and say that they'll be praying for us. In addition, after a stressful week, they ask how that week went. This is something that I will miss when I go off to college. Furthermore, I will miss Mr. Waldy outside directing traffic, Mrs. Ware saying hi to every single grammar student that walks in the door, Mrs. Hobson joyfully singing the Skeletal System song while holding her Starbucks coffee, and Mr. Maruna asking about our 10-second adventure every single weekend. I could go on and name every teacher, but for the sake of time, I won't. In summary, I will miss all the teachers in their unique ways. As I now anticipate the next chapter of my life, I'm thankful for the education which I have received, the opportunities to grow in my faith, and the relationships developed with the students and the teachers.
See our string musicians getting ready over here. At this point, I'd like to ask Amanda Walker, our string instructor here at Mars Hill, to come forward and introduce her students and to say a little bit about the strings program at Mars Hill. So, Amanda, thank you.
Hello, as Mr. McKenna just said, my name is Amanda Walker, and I direct the string orchestra program here at Mars Hill. And this evening, we have a few of our Junior Highlander and Highlander String Ensemble members with us, and we are going to share just one song for you. It's our favorite fiddle song, Boil Them Cabbage Down. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
All right, so you got to hear our strings program play a little bit here, but now I get to speak to you a little bit more about my experiences at Mars Hill Academy. Currently, I direct our string orchestra program, but my journey at Mars Hill Academy began when I was a third grade student the very first year the school opened back in 1996. I probably wouldn't have anticipated that I'd still be here 25 years later, but so glad that I am. Looking back on that first day of school at Mars Hill in the third grade, I didn't know what to expect of my new school or of the caliber of education I would receive here. I was excited to wear a new uniform, meet new classmates, and start learning Latin and grammar chants. Little did I know that this new school would play such an important role in shaping who I would become and my outlook on life. On that first day of third grade, I began to experience both the Christian love and the academics that characterize a Mars Hill education. Through my classes in the grammar, logic, and rhetoric stages, I developed good study habits, a wonderful love of learning, and the ability to critically think about all things from a biblical worldview. My education at Mars Hill prepared me well for college. After 10 years as an MHA student, I graduated and went on to study music at Hillsdale College and later earn a master's degree at Bowling Green State University. Mars Hill gave me not only the knowledge, but more importantly, the learning tools that I needed to succeed in college and beyond. Studying in a secular university for graduate school made me very grateful for the solid biblical foundation I gained at Mars Hill, where we learned how to apply Christian faith to all aspects of life and evaluate all things in light of the scriptures. However, I couldn't stay away from Mars Hill for too long. When I graduated with my master's, the school had an opening in the music department, and I returned to Mars Hill as a teacher. Through teaching music classes and starting the string orchestra program, I had the opportunity to share my passion for music with my students and help them to experience God's beauty through music. It was great to be a part of the MHA community again and work alongside wonderful colleagues, many of whom had been my teachers when I was a student. Each of the teachers here exhibit a godly maturity, a sincere love for their students, and a passion for their subject matter. It was truly a blessing to work in an environment where Christ is glorified and where teachers intentionally partner with parents to educate their children. Last school year, I stepped down from full-time teaching after the birth of my daughter, and it has been a joy to spend my days with her. But however, I still couldn't leave Mars Hill altogether, and it has been a delight to continue the strings program. Now, as a parent, I see the value of a Mars Hill education in a whole new light. My husband, Brad, and I believe strongly in the importance of a classical Christian education for our children and know that this will be the right place for them. I hope that my daughter and her soon-to-be-born baby sister will experience the joys and blessings of a Mars Hill education as well. Over the past 25 years, I've watched Mars Hill Academy grow from a group of 27 students and three teachers meeting in a church basement to the almost 300 students who now are blessed with a beautiful building and campus of their own. Although many things have changed over the years, the school's commitment to providing a solid education and what is true and good and beautiful has remained the same. From student to teacher to parent, I am so grateful for how Mars Hill Academy has influenced my life. Thank you.
This time I'd like to introduce our third and fourth grade singers, led by Corey Graham and accompanied by Amanda Walker and Tate Bailey.
Get your mallets. Go. That was our musical interlude, your down, that was intermission. So we are going to play two songs for you tonight on our wonderful ORF instruments. These are our ORF instruments designed by a composer named Carl ORF. We use them in the music room quite often. And I come with a big thank you from all the music students because these were purchased with money raised from our virtual hoedown last year. So we wanted to show them off. Yes, we'll celebrate that. Your amazing generosity. So the students tonight are going to give you a little preview of what we'll be doing for our Little House on the Prairie sing-along on the 22nd. If you happen to be free, we would love to have you.
I'm from Alabama with a banjo on my knee.
Yep.
Tate, I didn't know you played. Now I've got my eye on you for other things. At this time, I'd like to ask Tate Bailey and his dad to come up and share with you a father and son perspective on their time at Mars Hill. Thank you, boys.
Okay, my name is Tate Bailey. I am a Mars Hill 7th grader. One of the things I most appreciate about Mars Hill is the teachers. Like Kara Admiral said, you actually get to have a good relationship with your teacher. They invest their time and their energy in you, and they make sure that you learn the material well that they're giving you. One of my favorite teachers in that regard is Mr. Geese, who made me retake a Latin quiz about 5 times before I passed. So, took a while and took a lot of recesses. I think one of the most important things your teachers teach you is they try to strengthen your bond with God. And so, through his creation, through our earth science classes, through his word itself, through our Old Testament classes, and interpreting the Bible. They also help your relationship with your classmates. So the small community at Mars Hill, you're friends with everybody, and there's no one you can't really be friends with. So you know all of your teachers, all the students at Mars Hill. Seniors especially have really been helpful through the mentor program this year, teaching us seventh graders good study habits and good ways to take notes. They've also been great friends, and I feel like this year we've gone through a lot more bonding between students between multiple grades, so through the volleyball challenges and all that. So I think I'm going to hand it over to my dad.
They say that comparisons are odious, but I want to make some comparisons. And the comparison I want to make is I want you to think about the other alternatives to Mars Hill Academy. And I know several people who are here tonight or in the school because of the alternatives. And that's negative. That's somewhat odious, if you think about it. You'd prefer that everybody was just here because, you know, Mars Hill is amazing. The fact is, Mars Hill is amazing. It's particularly amazing when you think about the other options. And one of the things that we're very thankful for is that there are teachers here who will make our son stay in for 5 recesses and retake Latin quizzes. Yeah. The fact that there's discipline here in the school and that students are expected to produce their best and that teachers actually know what the best is that that student can do is very important and very, very helpful to us as parents as we seek to bring our students up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord and to get the best out of our kids. And so when we think of Mars Hill, you obviously have to think immediately of the teachers day in, day out, working hard. This last year, you know, we didn't get to have this gathering. We had a silent auction that was really silent, wasn't it? Nobody was there. Well, one of the things that stood out to me was the extra hard work that the teachers did through that time frame. It was remarkable to me, the work that the teachers did. You can't talk, yeah. Keep going. Ring them louder. I don't know how they did it personally. I know some of the families didn't know how they did it either, but I thought the teachers had it worse of all. Now, you can talk about the teachers for a long time, and really it deserves a few hours. The board at Mars Hill were very, very thankful for as well. And I don't know all the board members, but the ones that I do and I've gotten to know and I've gotten to work alongside, just giving of themselves selflessly, some of them for decades now. They have given and given and given in service to our children. Before our children were born, they were giving of themselves in service to our children. Think about that. It's remarkable, the gifts that they have given and that they've poured out on us. And the previous generations that we get to benefit from the building, for example, the building is nothing compared to the building of the school that they have done, that they've given themselves to. So I'm particularly thankful for the board members. But you know who brought us into this school? It was the front office staff and the administrators. And I'll just end by saying, I have been in plenty of schools, and I have met plenty of administrators, and I have never experienced the joy of coming into a school like walking into Mars Hill. So maybe the biggest bell ring ever for the front office staff.
You know, normally when I go out to dinner with my wife or something and we're sitting in the restaurant and I see people all around me on their phones, I go, oh, man, that's so sad. And then I look out here at the sea of everybody on their phones and I'm going, yeah, go, go. Context is everything. Before I introduce our final musical group this evening, I just want to mention you, if you have been paying attention to your phones, you may have just gotten a text saying that we're extending bidding till 7:15. So that will be going on till 7:15, so take advantage of that. At this point, I would like to introduce our faculty and staff entertainment for the evening, the three amigos, James Waldy, Tim Geese, and Dave Liebing. Give them a warm hand. He took my chair. That's all right. I can stand up. No, you stay here. You stay here. Okay. No, that's all right. That's all right. That's okay. That's good. So back in that time when the students were away, we had a little time on our hands. And so every once in a while, we'd get together and do a little bit of music. Yeah, that's what we called it. All right, so anyhow, was anybody listening to WLW today in the afternoon? They were interviewing a gal from Cincinnati. Somewhere in Ohio. And she was she lives down in Florida now. And her occupation is a python hunter. She hunts pythons. They have this huge, infestation of pythons that escaped down there, and they're decimating the mammal population. And I thought, how does she do that? She's 5'4", 120 pounds, and she was handling a 17-foot python. Well, I'll tell you how she did it. She bopped them in the head, and she took them away. Can you say that? She bopped them in the head, and it took them away. Can you do that? Go. You bop them in the head and you took them away. You're gonna see that, because we got a little song about Jake, who's a rattlesnake. Jake, the rattlesnake, lives up by that mountain lake. Eat those frogs all day long and just sit back down and sing this song. It's a Frogs, they're so fine. First the eyes and then the spine. Then that tail goes around. It's like eating ice cream on a hot, hot day. Yeah. Oh yeah, Jake, the rattlesnake, lives up by that mountain lake. And along came a man one day, and what'd he do? Well, he bop him in the head and he took him away. Yeah, bop him in the head and he took him away. He bop him in the head and he took him away. He bop him in the head and he took him away. Well, Blake, the rattlesnake, moved in on his cousin Jake. Frogs are fine, but so are mice. Yo, they go down mighty nice. Mice, they're so fine. First the eyes and then the spine. And then that tail, it moves around. And it wiggles and it jiggles and it goes right down. Oh, Blake, the rattlesnake, moved in on his cousin Jake. And along came a man one day. And what'd that man do? Well, he bop him in the head and he took him away. Hey, bop him in the head and he took him away. Hey, bop him in the head and he took him away. Hey, bop him in the head and he took him away. And that man goes singing away. He goes, hmm, 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 hmm. That's the story of Jake the rattlesnake. Hey, we got a ringy there. Oh, can you hold that up a second? It's falling down on me. Yep. No, I don't want that. I don't want that one either. Well, speaking of critters like that, you know all God's critters got a place in the choir. Yep. You ready? Okay. All God's critters got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws or anything they got now. Well, listen to the bass. It's the one on the bottom where the bullfrog croaks and the hippopotamus moans and goes with a big to-do. The old cow just says, well, the dogs and the cats that take up the middle, and the honeybee hums and the crickets fiddle, the donkey brays and the pony neighs, the old coyote howls.
All God's created got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws or anything they got now. Well, listen to the top where the little bird sings, a melody with her high voice ringing. The hoot owl howls over everything, and the jaybird disagrees. Singing in the nighttime, singing in the day, the little duck quacks and is on his way. The possum don't have much to say, and the porcupine talks to herself. All God's critters got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud on the telephone wire. None don't slap their hands or paws or anything hot now. Yeah, everybody here is a part of the plan. We all get to sing in the great critter band. From the eagle in the sky to the whale in the sea, it's one great symphony. Yeah, all God's critters got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher, some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws or anything they got now.
Thank you.
There you go, you big rabbit.
Can you hear me now? How many of you enjoyed your evening so far? I have a funny story to tell you. My children wanted me to bid on the dog. We have a dog. I don't want another dog. And I thought, surely, we'll bid on the dog, and we will tell them we bid on the dog and we were outbid. And until about a minute before it closed, Chris and I were sweating it out over here. And then my mother grabs my arm and goes, oh, someone outbid us. So thank you. That's right. That's right. One day last spring, I was sitting in the advancement office when I overheard a young man being asked what he thought after his visit to Mars Hill. It's better than Disney World, he shouted excitedly. I chuckled at his enthusiasm, and the marketing person in me wished I had gotten a recording of that moment. As someone who grew up going to Disney World as frequently as most of us go to Kings Island, I've considered what it means for MHA to be better than Disney World. If you haven't been to Disney World, there simply isn't anything quite like it. For those of you who have been, there's something magical about the place. I marvel at the creativity of the Imagineers who design the rides, or the spectacular shows in the theming, and even the customer service of the cast members. Walt Disney himself had an incredible vision for transforming what many considered unusable swampland in Central Florida into what has become the most visited vacation resort in the world. Better than Disney World is a high compliment indeed. Can you remember the magic of your first visit to Mars Hill Academy? Did you marvel at the creativity of the students' artwork throughout the halls? Were you blown away by an amazing drama or concert performance? Maybe you were left with a sense that the teachers and the staff have a true love for the Lord and for their students. Were you amazed by a vision to transform the landscape of education? Some might call it an unusable swampland, and reclaim it for Christ. I remember distinctly the first time I walked through the halls at Mars Hill. I'd known about the school long before Chris and I had children. We went to church with families like the Thistletons, the Hobsons, the Brinkerhoffs, Pinars, Admirals, Chernicons. 12 years ago, Amy Chernikon, who must have sensed that I have a hard time telling people no, asked me to come to an open house. Kaya was 3. I came, and the nerd in me visited classes from kindergarten through rhetoric school science and calculus, and I walked away knowing that the impossible had happened. I grew up going to public schools. Chris was homeschooled and graduated from a traditional Christian high school. And there were things that we both wanted and thought we would never find, from a thoroughly integrated Christian curriculum and high academic excellence to uniforms and yes ma'ams and no sirs. When I got home, I told Chris, I found our school. He was like, why would we drive 25 minutes when we have an option 10 minutes down the road? And I told him, you simply have to see it to believe it. All of our children desperately need a school like Mars Hill in today's world where truth, beauty, and goodness are questioned at every turn. When we chose Mars Hill for our families, we weren't just investing in academic knowledge. We are investing in a mission and vision committed to equipping our children for the transformational work of Christ in this world. Our gifts tonight are about something bigger than this school year. They are about supporting the next generation to learn real truth, to love what God says is beautiful, and to live lives of goodness to His glory. Our paddle race tonight includes tangible things that will enhance the school experience. But more importantly, tonight's paddle raise will raise money for the intangible gift of ensuring other children just like ours receive the gift of a Mars Hill education. I'm gonna take a minute to tell you what our paddle raise is in support of. Scripture tells us in Romans 12, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. As we ask that our children are going to learn truth, some of the items that you're going to support will enhance the curriculum for grammar, logic, and our rhetoric school students. And we use our gym to hold convocations where we share the truth. And so we want an improved projector display so they can actually see well what we're trying to teach them. As we seek to pursue beauty, we're going to implement a classical Christian education display similar to what we have for our trophy cases, but that allow us to highlight who we are as Christ followers, who we are as a classical education school. We also are going to look at improving our classrooms with some classroom mural art and some high-quality maps. It may seem funny to say this is beautiful, but if you've ever watched a soccer game and you've seen them kick the ball down across the road and run across to go get it, narrowly missing cars and people, we're gonna put a stop in at that end so that that doesn't happen anymore. And then, we're, Lord willing, it's gonna be beautiful. We'd like to get a Highlander mascot costume. But finally, as we seek to pursue living goodness, we ask that your paddle raises go to support our tuition assistance scholarships. This is a gift that makes Mars Hill's classical Christian education a reality for children and their families who want to be here regardless of their financial circumstances. So I want to take a minute to explain how the paddle raise will work. You'll get a text message that's sent to your phone, and you can click there to go to the different giving levels. If any of you have problems, you can raise your hand. Mrs. Cotterman and Mrs. Hall will be able to assist anyone who needs help. After last year, it's probably going to be pretty easy for you. And so tonight, I'm asking you to raise your virtual paddles and ring your cowbells to support the truth, beauty, and goodness at Mars Hill. And where's Nick? Anybody see Nick Keekley? He's my auctioneer.
not Joe. I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? But I hadn't been for Cotton Eye Joe. I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
He did a really good job in March. But I guess we're going with Cletus. Are you willing to do it until we go to the hoedown?
Well, I don't know about that Nick feller. If he told you he was going to be here, he ought to show up. But since he's not here, I'll be happy to do it for you, Mrs. Knoller.
I'm a little nervous to ask what is in your bag.
Oh, well, you know, the last time I was here, my buddy Bert, he was hanging out underneath the bleachers. You might remember that. He's a little shy, but he might be willing to make an appearance tonight. So, Mrs. Canola, maybe you can coax Bert right on out of his bag here. Just say, "Hello, Bert." Real nice and sweet. Like, he really likes that.
Is that necessary?
let me say it again. "Hello, Bert." Come on, let's see it, Mrs. Knoller.
"Hello, Bert."
You know, Mrs. Knoller, for a school known for its excellence, I'm not sure that counts. I think you're gonna have to try again and yeah, Bert, hang on. He's not used to crowds like this, everybody. Just hang on now. Let's try this again. Except I see you got one of them cowbells. If you ring your cowbell, he might think it's dinner time. So we're gonna go, "Hello, Bert." Hold right there, ring that bell. Okay, go ahead. But we'll see if he comes out. He's like right there, I can see it.
With excellence, right?
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Darn too.
"Hello, Bert."
I see you're not the only one with a cowbell. You know, Bert's still not coming out. I think he's going to need all your help also. So if you guys could just grab your cowbell on the count of three, we're going to say, "Hello, Bert," and shake those cowbells, all right? Are you ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. "Hello, Bert!" There he is. "Say hello, Bert." He says hello. Mrs. Knoller, did you just see that?
I see Bert.
No, no. They all just committed to $10,000 each. We're going to square this.
It doesn't quite work that way.
Oh, okay.
The cowbells are for fun.
That was fun.
They're going to bid on their phones.
Uh-huh.
And then ring the bell for fun. Oh. Not committing $10,000 each.
It's okay if they commit $10,000 each. All right, yeah. Well, that's pretty fancy. Why don't you say we go ahead and get this paddle race started?
You ready? Let's shake our paddles if we're... Or paddles. I know!
Can I take that microphone?
Thank you, Mayor and Mrs. Knoedler. Well, hey, it is great to be with all of you this evening. I hope you save me some baked beans or some green beans. Really, any kind of bean to do all right. We're going to go ahead and get started at the $25,000 level tonight. But I got some really wonderful news to share with you. We are already at almost $34,000 before we've even got started. Woo! Yeehaw! For those of you who are joining virtually tonight, this is when you turn the knob up on your television and start listening and paying more attention. We need your help at home, too. That's right. It's a knob. We don't have none of them fancy clicker things like you all got down here. No siree. No siree. So, hey, next time we have this here shindig, I sure hope you guys can join us. All right. Thank you for the courtesy chuckle in the corner. Now, as you're thinking about how many $25,000 gifts you're going to give while I wipe that mosquito off my nose... Thank you for the courtesy chuckle right over here at table number 19. That's $25,000 right there. Do you see it? Hot diggity dog. Oh, man, we're off to a rip-roaring start now. Wow. All right. So, $25,000. Do I have anybody out there for $25,000? What a great way to show your investment in Mars Hill Academy. I got to tell you, though, something. Where I come from, $25,000 is a whole lot of possum tails. A whole lot of possum tails. Do I have anybody out there for $25,000? Oh my goodness! Did you just see what's up on the screen? We didn't get one, we just got two $25,000 gifts! Oh my goodness! Wow, what a great start! What a great start! You know, as in prior years, as probably Mrs. Knoedler already shared with you, your gifts tonight are going to go to help out many things. Academic instruction, facilities, beautification of our fine building and grounds, and my personal favorite, student transportation in the form of two donkeys. If we can just get to that 100,000 level, I think we'll get them donkeys. That's right. She's going to regret this before the end of the night, so. Oh, goodness. All right. One more time at 25,000. Go once, twice, three times a lady. All right. We're going to move on to our $10,000 giving level. Look at this. We're at $85,000 already. 85% of the way up. We are going to smoke away our goal for tonight. This is already going to be a wonderful, wonderful evening. I can tell Brian Minnick is wishing that he's up here doing this. I mean, he'll be doing it next year. All right. Now, as you're thinking about your gifts, please, please consider the outstanding teachers and faculty, staff, and administration here at Mars Hill Academy who are investing in our children every day. No, they don't do dental work, but they teach our children pretty doggone good. The Lord has blessed our school with committed Christ followers who love their subjects, love their students, and love teaching at Mars Hill Academy. Mike calls that the four loves, and I love the four loves. It's pretty doggone good. Your generosity tonight becomes a tangible way of demonstrating your generosity, support, and love for the teachers here at this school. So, could you please give some consideration tonight to a contribution at $10,000? Perhaps one of our friends at home would like to pitch in at this level. Doggone those P words. They're so hard with these teeth. Gotta lick my lip again. All right. We're still sitting at $85,000. Give it another couple of minutes here. Anybody else at $10,000? Hey, there we go. We got our first $10,000 gift. Give yourselves a hand. Let's hear them bells. Outstanding. Any more people here at $10,000? If you want to sell a couple of pigs, maybe a cow, you can raise that $10,000. We'll take them. We'll take them. Anybody else at $10,000? All right. Anybody else attend? Thank you. Thank you very much. All right. We're about to go to the $5,000 paddle raise level. Now, earlier I saw all your hands shaking up and down and bells are ringing. I think you got five fingers on. I think that means the rest of you are at the $5,000 level. So let's see what we got now at the $5,000 level. Again, we know this is a major commitment. We got our first one in. Look at that, folks. We are already over the goal. Woo! No, that wasn't good enough. One more time. Woo! Yeah! All right. Lisa's going to be crying a bucket of tears over here because we're already over 100. She's already in. Don't look at her. If you are a sympathetic crier, look out that window down there. Don't look over here. Nothing. There is nothing to see. All you sympathetic criers out there, just turn around. No, don't look over here. No. No. 110,000, you just snuck in under our noses. Oh my goodness. Maybe you should cry some more. Oh my word. 110,000. Thank you so much to everybody who has given tonight already. What a wonderful evening. We are moving on now to the $2,500 giving level. This represents another opportunity to help us exceed our goal and maybe even help us knock out our entire fundraising needs for the entire year in one night. Would that not be just amazing if we could pull that off? Woo! There we go. Two of them already in. So you might be wondering, if you needed 100, why do you need more? Well, the 100 helps us to achieve what I've learned from Mike. He calls it the margin of excellence in delivering education here at Mars Hill, kind of like my teeth. But we still have a lot of tuition assistance that we provide to families so that an education here is accessible to as many people as possible. And so now we are playing for keeps to help knock out the rest of that goal here tonight. And that is really exciting. That is really exciting. We got another gift at $2,500. Thank you. Thank you. Folks at home, keep that dial turned in here. Don't let me go to static on you now. All right. Now, we're about to go to the $1,000 giving level. Anybody else out there at $1,000? Anybody else? $117,682. Whew. All right. Well, at this point in the program, Mrs. Knodler asked me to get out an envelope. And as you can see, I have two problems, maybe three. I don't have my glasses. My hands are full. and I can't read. So, no, it's the right one. It's okay. I need that one later. Yeah. Daggone these fancy chords. You're going to trip me up. I need some help. Mrs. Musser, do you think you could open that envelope up? Man, she is a skilled envelope opener. Would you not agree with me? All right. Now, Mrs. Musser, I'm going to need you to read that to the audience when I pass this microphone to you. Just... It must be exciting. Okay. Now, I'm going to pass this microphone to you. Just talk right into it. I'll hold it for you, okay? Yeah, now, you just talk right into it. It's this part right here. I don't know how it works either. You talk into it, it comes out those black boxes over there. We don't have nothing like that down in Holler where I'm coming from. Let's try one more time.
Hi. It works. Okay. Each person giving at the $1,000 level tonight will receive a complimentary coonskin hat.
What? Miss Cornell, keep a close eye on Bert. He does not appreciate that, Mrs. Knoedler. Don't you people have any cooth up here at all? I mean, my goodness, for shame, for shame. Whew. And look at that, 10 people just signed up to get a coonskin hat. I can't believe it. Don't you worry, Bert. We're going to keep a good eye on you. That may have been one of your relatives, honey. We'll keep a good eye on you. That's right. Whew. Anybody else have $1,000 for a coonskin hat? Now I'm crying too. I guess there's no more. What's so funny? All right. Anybody else at the $1,000 giving level? All right, you're going to have to see Mrs. Knoedler for those coonskin hats, but don't let me see you grabbing one from her or wear around me. I've been taking that one right off your head. I can guarantee you that. Oh, hey, look at that. Three more people are signing up for coonskin hats. All right, $130,000. Let's move now to the $500 giving level. Here's where lots of families banding together, in addition to those who already have tonight, can make a real big impact. What if we could get another few $1,000 in $500 gifts? This would be a great chance. If you've been holding off, trying to figure out how to punch your TV to get it to contribute, maybe you could ask a neighbor why your TV is not working for you tonight. I don't know. I can't really help you with that very much. That gentleman right there in a hat might, though. He's a little busy right now. He'll talk to you later, though. There we go. Look at this. We're coming up on 134, 465. Can we get one more? One more to take us over to 135,000. One more $500 gift. We're so close. $35 away. $35 away. And we're at 135. Ring those bells. Hey, there we go. All right. Fantastic. Now, we're going to move to the $250 giving level. Let's keep hearing those bells ring. $250. Anybody out there for $250? For lots of us out there, we know budgets can be tight, hard to dig into that pocket to find a little bit more. Sometimes they're more month than money. I get it. Here's a chance. $250 to lend your support. Thank you. Thank you. We got them coming in. Look at these coming in, rolling in now, left and right. Thank you. Thank you to everybody contributing tonight and those of you at home. What a wonderful evening. We are almost 40% over target. This is really exciting, folks. All right. Now, we're about to move to the $100 giving level. Perhaps we've got some young alumni out there that would like to make a contribution, say thanks to a particular teacher. A way to say, hey, thanks to Mr. Cotterman for leading us 3 years in school during that transition period. thanks to their favorite kindergarten teacher of all time. Whoever that might be, for those young alums, there they go. They're rolling in now. 141.5, lots more people. Folks, I don't know if you realize, I think we just got $10,000 in contributions. Oh, I'm coming up on 11 now. In contributions from $100 to $500. Wow, that's what happens when we're all pulling it together. That is really, really interesting. I'll tell you what, this has been a special night. We're still not done. Mrs. Knoedler here said she had some kind of envelope for me. Do I still have an envelope coming?
This is the real one.
Oh, okay. All right, well, I got that same problem that I did before. I need a volunteer to oh. Mrs. Schatz, you're an accomplished third grade graduate, aren't you? Let's see if you're any better of a letter opener there than that Mrs. Musser. And then come on up here. I can't stretch that far, or if I could, I'd be afraid to see what happens. Okay, go ahead and read.
Really snazzy
one. I'll tell you what, that is snazzy. I got bow ties that don't look that good. All right, I'm going to hand the microphone to you.
I'm cool enough to hold it.
No, you're just cool enough to take it off my hands. I'll be lucky if I get it back now.
As the Mars Hill community comes together in special celebration this weekend, this gift of $25,000 is being made in honor of two beloved community members. Brian Hobson, the husband and teacher of Ruth Hobson, and Lindsay Campbell, the father and teacher of Michelle Augustine.
Whoa. Wow. Can we update our total for 25? There she goes. She's crying again. There she goes. She's crying so much she can't see straight to add 25 and three zeros after the end of it. I'll tell you what, I'll figure out how to stop crying for $25,000 right now. Well, there you go. You did it, Mrs. Knoedler. Give that woman a hand. Now, I told you this was going to be a good night, and it has been a good night. Ain't that right, Dr. Dowdy?
Yeah.
That's right, Dr. Dowdy right over there. I don't know about you, but that was an inspirational gift and a really wonderful way to remember Mrs. Hobson and Mrs. Augustine, two teachers here in our school, and their beloved family members. And this also is an opportunity for any of you who would like to add to and multiply that gift and add to it. And as it so happens, a family had approached me way down in the holler, not up here, way down in the holler, and told me that if something like this were to happen, they would like to add another $25,000 on top of that in honor of Mr. Hobson and Mr. Campbell. Can we get another $25,000 on top of that right there? Thank you to that family. You need to get a little louder. They're far away down the holler. Woo, yeah, woo. All right. Can we add 25? I tell you, you know, we just had chalkboards down home. You know, it's pretty easy to add 25 to 166.9. I don't know what your problem is up here now. 25, 191.9. Now, I'm going to tell you one more thing, folks. That there square dance is going to happen over that gym. It's going to be a whole lot more fun if I see a 2 and 5 zeros up here. A whole lot more fun. And if we get to 200,000, I think that means we get 4 donkeys instead of 2. How about it, folks? How can we get to 200,000? How can we get there? How can we get there? Anybody want to help us out? There we go. Let's do it. 192.1. 192.1. We're on our way. Every little bit helps, including those of you at home. Don't tune us out just yet. We're still here. You can still come to the square dance. We'll be here. I also heard 192.1. I also heard if we get to $200,000, that Steve Taylor will be manning the kissing booth at the square dance. Ain't that right, Steve? That's right. Steve Taylor in kissing booth. 192.2, we're on our way. Steve Taylor's going to start taking money away from that total so he doesn't have to man that kissing booth. Love you, Steve Taylor. Love you. Not enough to kiss you, but I still love you. That's right. Anybody else out there? Can we get to 200? 192.95. We are getting closer. We are getting closer. Do you know somebody who's not here tonight? Give them a call right now. Call them up and say, hey, we need, how much do we need? We need $4,300 to get us over the top. Make a phone call. Call somebody that you know and love, that you know loves this school. Tell them we need $4,300 to get to $200,000. That's right. Now you make these teeth go away. Woo! We're getting closer. We're getting closer. 196.95. I almost fell off the stage. I haven't even been drinking my corn from the bottle. Here we go. Yeah, let's keep clapping. 199.250. We are $750 away. $750 away. Who is going to get us them four donkeys? I want four donkeys. Can I get four? There we go. Woo! Let's go have us a square dance, folks. Yeah. All right.
I really don't know how to follow that. Wow, I was not a crier before I started working at Mars Hill. I'm sorry. This is the most we have ever raised in this event. It's been an amazing weekend, and there is a lot that goes into Grandparents' Day and our homecoming games and senior night and our hoedown, and there's no way I can possibly thank everyone who has been a part of it and everyone who has supported it tonight. And I'm going to tell you, it's a little crazy, the week leading up to it, and a mom asked me yesterday how I was doing. Are you doing okay, Lisa? How are you hanging in there? And I said, you know what? I'm resting in the fact that God shows up in amazing ways every time we come together to support the mission and vision of the school. And he does it again and again and again, and it makes it easier to go through an event like homecoming weekend, to know that for all of my faults and the things that don't come together quite the way I want to, God's in control. And isn't it amazing that we are trusting in him to educate our children through a gift like Mars Hill? So thank you so much for your support of our teachers, of our staff, and of our students. It's such a beautiful thing to watch us come together, not just like this, but to come together every day and get to sing praises to God, to hear the children's voices in the halls, to hear them worshiping together, and to see my almost 15-year-old excited to recite the same verses that her brother is learning in fourth grade, and to know that God's word is in her heart because of the transformational work of Mars Hill Academy. So thank you. I don't feel like I'm speaking very eloquently, but it's just overwhelming. And so thank you so much for all that you've given. And I think now it's time to go ahead. And if you've won your items, we can check out. And I think all of this deserves a great shindig in the gym. So thank you so much.